First and foremost, I am a psychologist and I'm also the director of student support services here at the University of Roehampton, which means I oversee counselling, disabilities, mental health, wellbeing and information teams, all of which are here to support students to reach their full potential. We support students through any difficulty that may arise during their time here, and this could really be anything, ranging from a mental health condition or experiencing a traumatic event or just in need of general support and guidance on anything that could be interfering with their daily functioning or getting in the way of studying and having a great time at Roehampton. A big part of my role is to drive forward strategies and initiatives around mental health, sexual violence, and anything to do with tackling barriers and stigmas. I'm often writing policies and strategies or taking part in projects which aim to enhance the student experience. I work very closely with colleagues around the institution to ensure that we're doing everything we can to improve the student life and create an environment where students feel safe and part of a community. Our aim is to support students to enjoy their time at Roehampton, achieve the goals they set for themselves, and go on to lead fulfilling lives while being mindfully aware citizens of the world. One of the main projects I'm working on right now is mitigating the impact that COVID has on our students by providing extra support and collaborating with other departments to ensure that we're proactively reaching out to students to find out how they are and if there's anything that they need to help them with their studies or their personal lives. This pandemic has been really challenging for most people, and it can be tricky to remain positive with so many uncertainties. The work we're doing is trying to remedy the impact it's having on mental health, particularly given the isolation and the loneliness that a lockdown creates. There are many things you can do to cope with lockdown, but the top five that I would recommend are stay connected, which could sound really impossible given that we're in a lockdown, but make sure you keep contact with your friends through text messaging or video calls or whatever medium you prefer. There's always ways to be creative with online socializing and networking, even though it's obviously not the same. It still does provide crucial interaction, and it makes a really big difference. The second I would recommend is to keep physically active. This is so hugely important for a number of reasons. It'll help boost your mental health because of the endorphins that are released, which triggers positive feelings. It can help you set goals and achieve them, which is also a really rewarding feeling. If you go outside for your physical activity, it'll be a chance to get fresh air. And it can also help with other aspects of your life, like sleep, appetite, and confidence. I also recommend to keep a routine or create one if you're furloughed or currently have less structure in your day. Set your alarm, get out of bed, take a shower, and remember to eat regular meals. All of this will help feel a sense of normality. You can set goals for each day or each week and do things that help you stay positive. The fourth I would recommend is to stay occupied. You can do this by trying something new, like baking a new recipe or doing a puzzle or doing workout videos or something really creative like painting. There really are so many things that you can be doing. Sometimes it's just a matter of thinking creatively and checking out what your options are. This does include relaxation and mindfulness as well. It's important that you stay really present and grounded and focus your mind on other things, perhaps reminding yourself what you're grateful for. And the final one, which is a good one and hopefully you all can relate and draw upon, is have fun. Do whatever you can to have fun, adhering to the government guidelines, of course. It's a difficult time for us all, but that doesn't mean that the time has to pass us by. My favorite one for many reasons is being physically active. I absolutely love running and cycling. It allows me to set goals in terms of distance and mileage, and it also allows me to get fresh air and the feeling like I've achieved something that day. As a psychologist, I'm hyper aware of what activities benefit our mental health, and I'd argue that being physically active is one of the most important things to do. Well, I've been at Roehampton for 9 years now, so you can imagine how many wonderful highlights there's been. I actually started as a student on the counseling psychology doctoral program, and I guess my proudest moment was walking across that stage for graduation and feeling so exhilarated that I'd finally achieved an enormous goal of mine, while also meeting the most amazing friends and making the most amazing memories as well. Roehampton really is good for all of those things. But I suppose in terms of career-wise, the highlight would have to be having such an exceptional team who work so unimaginably hard to support our students. They're all such incredible people and they dedicate tons of their own time and emotion into ensuring that our students have an enriched student experience. And I'm just, yeah, really lucky to work with all of them. I have many, but if I had to choose just one favorite, I'd say that it's the lawn of Whitelands College, right at the end where you can look over onto Richmond Park. And just a tip for you Whitelands students who might be watching this video, it's an ideal place to watch the sunset as well, which I did so many times when I was a student living here.